this year, one of the things we're super excited about at Radio Theology is being a part of the Activate Indy Network. We've talked about it all year, but we have 9 phenomenal nonprofit partners this year that are creating turnkey, amazing opportunities to serve in the Indianapolis area, to make a difference, to see faith, hope, and love create the future of our city. And we're so excited today to have Danyele Easterhaus with us from Student Impact. And Student Impact is a phenomenal ministry, been around for 20 years in our city. And really what they do is they connect with students. And that it's even more than that. We're going to talk about the house that you guys have called The Rock, inspiring stuff happening there. But Student Impact, you guys build relationships to develop student leaders who help raise up followers of Christ, create a positive and inclusive Christian atmosphere, and foster a healing community. So stoked to have Danyele with us. And you brought one of your student leaders, Sadie, with us today. And so we're going to jump right in. But ladies, thanks so much for being on the podcast.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. So Danyele, you have been a part of Student Impact. It's been around for 20 years here in Indianapolis. And where is Student Impact?
Student Impact's located in downtown Westfield, walking distance from all of the schools, which makes it the perfect location for kids to be a hub after school to provide that safe and consistent place.
Very cool. And so you've been on staff, you said, for 8 years, but Yes. You've been a part. You've been a part of the mix since it started 20 years ago.
Yeah, a great man by the name of Dan Fentling started Student Impact. Great visionary. Basically, went out into the community and said, "What does Westfield need?" And unequivocally, the answer was a safe place for kids. So that birthed Student Impact. And so Student Impact builds relationships that bring hope and healing to students through Christ. And so it's just been a great opportunity to see it grow from a few kids that wanted to be able to do Bible study into what it's become today.
Yeah. You know, Danyele, I think one of the things we're excited about with Activate Indy is to get people involved. I think one of the things that changes our lives is when we take on the posture and the identity of a servant. I think it's what Christ, I know it is, it's what Christ has asked us to do. It's what he did. And so we want to invite people into that life-changing experience. And one of the things I think that is key is for people to get to know the stories a little bit of the people that are running the organizations and leading the organizations that we're pointing people to. And so you've been on staff with Student Impact for 8 years. I think it's funny, in the bio you sent us, you said you grew up in a home where you picked up hitchhikers and bikers on family road trips.
That's so, absolutely true.
So it sounds like you had some early DNA to be able to make it make sense for you to work with like junior hires and high school students, right? So give me a story about picking up hitchhikers.
So we used to take trips to Florida every year, and I'll never forget my dad had a Ford pickup with one of those cab things on the back.
Yeah.
And I had one brother, and they would just throw a mattress in the back of it, and we'd sit in the back of that car, and we'd fight till death if we needed to, right?
So you showed up in Florida?
Yeah, and when we showed up in Florida, everybody got out and went to the hotel. It was great.
Yeah.
But, yeah, every time my dad was a biker, and so every time we'd see a biker, I'll never forget in Tennessee one year we had two guys that their bikes had broken down, and they just got in the back of the pickup with us. And we rode like 150 miles, and they played like Uno. They taught us how to play poker. I mean, I was like 12, maybe. Yeah. But I mean, just nobody was ever not part of who we were as kids. So I never saw anything different in people. I just never saw an us versus them. And so I think it really forged a way in my life to be able to see everyone for who they were created for. I think my parents have always done a great job of that. And so for me, with students, I don't look at kids and see different groups. I look at kids and see like little creations of fun stuff that just wants a place to belong.
Yeah, yeah. So, there's definitely a spirit of adventure and hospitality there. Was that shaped as a kid from a perspective of faith with your parents?
Yes. I mean, I grew up, my mom and dad have always been very active in church. And just really, we always knew that God was with us. I can remember my dad was an automotive worker in the 70s when everything was on strike. And I can actually remember sitting at the dinner table praying that somebody would deliver us food. And I'll never forget that it always happened.
Wow.
There was one time when I was younger, we were praying. We just didn't know how we were going to pay the bills. And so mom told me to go out to the mailbox and get the mail. And there was a $100 bill in the mail, just in the mailbox sitting there.
Wow.
Like, I have never, ever questioned that my parents built that faith in me. Mm-hmm. obviously. There was always a time where I've wandered from that faith. Please don't misunderstand me.
Sure. It's a journey, right?
Which is why I really like working with kids, because we can come back around. But, you know, I've never doubted that God was with me.
Yeah.
And so that's such a special gift. Like, a lot of people just haven't had that gift.
Yeah.
Man, if there's one thing that I want people to know, like, God's real. He's here for you. He's not against you. He wants the best for you. And I guess I just always knew that. So I really want to show people how to do that.
Yeah.
And especially kids.
So for you, I mean, that was the roots for you, Danyele. But as a kid, did you grow up feeling like, you know, really what I want to do in life? I want to work with teens in Westfield, Indiana. Or what did you think was your, you know, life path early?
This is God's truth.
Yeah.
Okay. I was born in July of 1969.
Okay.
I just turned 50.
Okay.
And my whole life have wanted to be an astronaut. That's
really
all I ever wanted to be. And I know you can't see me, but I am 4'9". Okay. So, tidbit of information, astronauts have to be a little bigger than that. And so I just became a mechanical engineer.
Because that's usually the next step. It's like, hey, if you can't make the cut, astronaut,
then design
it. Mechanical engineer.
Yeah, just design it. So yeah, and I'm a total gearhead. I rebuild motors. I've got a 66 Mustang. That's kind of my thing. I just like to work with stuff and see it transform. Like to flip houses, like to do all that kind of just transformation kind of stuff. And so, yeah, but I can remember on a retreat in my 30s, which doesn't seem that long ago as a side note, that one of those questions, the opening question is, if you could do anything where time and money didn't matter, what would you do?
Yeah.
And I can remember the answer was, I'd hang out with high school kids every single day.
Really?
I just have always loved it. Like, even tonight, we're having one of my students she turns 18 today, and we always let our house be the house that everybody can be at.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so you want to have a party? Come and be at our house. So all the girls are coming tonight to have a big pool party at our house for an 18th birthday party and a bonfire and a cookout, and we'll all just hang inside so they can do it.
Right.
It was always a desire for me to have a place that was just safe for kids to be, and I love that we can do that now.
Yeah. So that's the heart behind your leadership and your servant and what you're doing with Student Impact. Talk to us about The Rock, because you guys have created a facility there in Westfield where you're able to do exactly what you just unpacked for us. Tell us about The Rock.
Yeah, The Rock is literally a house. And one of the things that we discovered early on is that a lot of people who have been hurt by either the church or by the schools, by either being, like, my dad was the kid that got kicked out of 4 schools, right? Mm. So you hosting in a school isn't always a great feel for a lot of parents, or some kids' school isn't a great place. The Rock is just a house.
Okay.
It's literally just a house. And it's set up just like a house. So it has a living room and a dining room, and it has everything. But the cool part is that we've transformed the living room into a gaming room, and we have talking areas, and we've got some art areas, and we've got foosball. But the whole goal in The Rock is to provide that safe, consistent place that every time you walk through the door, you know that the same people are going to be there. There's always a fresh, hot meal. And you've got a lot of student leaders like Sadie that are hanging out there to build relationships with kids. So when they walk through the halls of school, they have a familiar, smiling face that if something's going on, they can at least go, Sadie, I need help.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, Sadie, you're a senior at Westfield. Is that correct?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so how long have you been a part of Student Impact?
I have been a part of Student Impact since 5th grade, and that's when we start kids off, 5th through 12th grade. And I have actually been, this is my 3rd year being a student leader, and I'm also going to be an intern this year. Very excited for that.
Absolutely. So what drew you to want to be a part of it?
Well, definitely a lot of kids I grew up with actually went to Student Impact, and I also knew Danyele growing up, and so it always looked really fun. I know, like, it's a great place to join, and a lot of kids my age would talk about, we have this thing called Rock Moment, and we sit there, and they'll teach you a Bible verse and everything, and I was always really interested in, like, my faith, and so I came to just, like, have a really safe place to hang out with my friends, but also learn more about God.
Yeah, for you, Sadie, has there been a moment in your being a student leader with Student Impact where, I guess a time you've been able to come beside another student that really changed your life or impacted it for the better?
Definitely. At Student Impact, we have a, like, very big variety of kids that come in and walk through our doors. I know I've heard a lot of stories of how these kids have grown up and like all the troubles they have been through. And it's really cool that they trust me to talk about their feelings and all of these things that have happened to them. And I kind of just try and be there for them. And I love to hear their updates of how like things that are going well in their lives now and see how it can just completely turn around from like just having a really horrible childhood to coming to a school in a place where they make friends and they start to really enjoy what they're doing and everything like that.
Wow. I love it. I love it. Danyele, I guess one of the things that we want to see happen with ACTIVATEINDY this year is to see people, you know, partner up with you guys,
right,
bring groups of people to come and volunteer, you know, to build it, to impact a life like Sadie's talking about, to impact lives like, you know, like you've talked about. So what are some opportunities that are available if people wanted in the Westfield area, wanted to get involved and volunteer with you guys?
So there are three different areas that Student Impact focuses on. We have The Rock, which is our after-school ministry that really is the crux, like the base of what we do. Mm. The whole focus ultimately at The Rock is to be able to connect a kid with a church body.
Okay.
Because after high school, I can't help them anymore. I'm not equipped to do that. So they need some kind of church-focused body to help them on that. And we're not affiliated with any church at all. We're our own thing. So that's kind of that. The second part is the community. We do a lot of community service. And then the third part is our sports program. We have about 450 kids in our basketball leagues.
Get out of here.
Yeah. I mean, it's not a small endeavor. And we play this year. It's fantastic. We'll be having we've played for the last number of years at the Pacers Athletic Center in Grand Park.
Yeah.
But this year we have the entire facility for Friday night.
Oh, wow.
So we can really pray up that facility, which will be really awesome. And we can showcase some churches, showcase some different things like what you all do, just different things so people can see that there's other ways to be around. But with 450 kids playing basketball, you need a lot of really great leaders to coach.
Sure.
And it takes a lot of people to do that. So that's, you know, I always tell people after school, what I really need is guys to come and play basketball for an hour and build relationships. Okay, so that's a huge thing for me because kids want deep, devoted relationships with people. And so playing basketball with kids on premise is huge, 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 huge. Also, checkers. If you like to play checkers, Uno. I mean, I'm telling you, we can kill Uno. Can we not kill Uno?
Every
Uno
day.
Attack. I'm telling you right now, queens right here. We are crazy with Uno attack. So, you know, people that just want to hang out with kids.
Yeah.
And here's the deal. Kids are not scary. Okay. You know what they need is like somebody that's just super real and that wants to be with them.
Yeah.
So you don't have to have a degree. I don't have a degree in it. I'm a mechanical engineer. I can design OnStar, but I have no idea how to do the mind of a child, okay? But I play Uno really well.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's that. The final thing that I'd say is we just need lots of people to, like, make the place run. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
We feed a fresh, hot meal every single day. So we ask church groups or small groups or neighborhood groups to make casseroles that their family likes, whatever their favorite casserole of the day is.
Yeah.
And then we bring them, we freeze them, and then we make a fresh casserole every day for kids. Because wow. We're finding out that 20 to 30% of the kids that we serve, even in Westfield, don't get dinner at night.
Yeah.
And so we want to feed them, because if we don't feed their bellies, we can't feed their souls, man. Yeah. We've got to be able to figure that out.
Wow. But, you know, Dan, I think it's so often people, you know, they go through their Monday, you know, through Friday, and maybe faith is a part of it, or maybe they're new to a walk with Christ, and they're trying to figure out, what do I need to do to find greater purpose and meaning in my life? And the longer I live, you know, the words of the scriptures just continue to become more and more true. And the example of Christ is that if the sole purpose of your life is your own joy and happiness and stuff,
right,
it will not fill your soul. We are meant to serve and to love and to walk beside you know, others, and it's through that process that we find the purpose, that we find the passion, we find the joy. And I think often we make that seem so difficult, like,
it's,
man,
so not.
Yeah, I just don't know if I could make a difference, whatever. It's like, if you can play basketball and you have
right.
two ears, right? And
right.
you can listen
this is
and
not
be present.
Difficult.
Yeah.
It's just not. And that's what I tell people all the time. Everyone has a special gift, okay? And it doesn't have to be that you can sing. I can't sing at all. I mean, and if I did, we'd take the building down. The kids all laugh at me when we do worship. Yes. They're all like, Danyele, don't sing. So, but, you know, we all don't have the same things, but everyone wants to be loved.
Yeah.
Everyone. And in the way that you can define that love, it's just critical. You know, it's so simple, but I have a lady that loves to organize. Like, that's her gift. Yeah. She does not want to be around students at all. But when I have new stuff come in, I'll call her and say, hey, it's time for you to come and organize for me. And she loves that.
Yeah.
And so she'll come in and organize. That's a special gift because I don't have time to do that.
Right.
And, you know, the people that make the casseroles, huge. What a great, like, neighbor project.
Yeah.
Be like, hey, I'm going to make all the ground beef. You bring the cheese or whatever you decide on your casseroles. I mean, what a great idea.
Yeah.
And these kids, what you're giving these kids is more than a meal. Right? What these kids hear every day from us is somebody that didn't know you took time to make this meal for you, and we're serving it to you because you matter to God.
Oh, wow.
This meal is more than a casserole.
Yeah.
This, you know, and when you play Uno with these kids at the table, it's far more than Uno, because what do I learn about these kids, right? I learned that life is hard, and when they get angry, when they lose, why is that?
Yeah.
You know, and you can really build that in, and, you know, lawn mowing. That's a huge need. Somebody's got to mow my lawn. Are you gifted at that? I got a place for you.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to clean my toilets. FYI, kids stink. That's a really good thing. Like, you know, we need cleaners. Lots of cleaners.
Yeah.
Imagine 200 kids coming through your building, your house,
yeah,
in a week.
In a week.
Cleaners are so important.
Well, Danyele, I think one thing that discourages me sometimes, or, you know, I'm a pretty positive person, but I can get, you know, discouraged sometimes when I just read the news and it's, you know, the bad things that happen, and you're reading a story about, man, how did, you know, if a young person has done something, some kind of crime or something, I think to myself, man, what happened to that kid? You know, like, how do you go from being, you know, just a seemingly regular, happy kid to commit some kind of crime like that, or to do something, whatever it would be? And what I think about as you were just talking is about, what if, you know, some of those kids that may make decisions that completely derail their life, like, what if they would have had someone to play basketball with them? What if they just sat across the table and played Uno with someone? What if they would have had that night where they didn't have that meal that somebody, you know, made casserole for them? And I think the thing is, we can get so discouraged by the negative we see in the world and think, man, I can't do anything to change the world. But what I love what you guys are doing with Student Impact, you're saying, yes, you can. If you could make a casserole once a week, you could help change the world. If you could play Uno, if you could talk to a kid, if you're already playing basketball, like, come over and be a part of helping coach one of these teams and sit with these kids, because it's going to be those moments that a kid's going to look back on and say, you know what, my life changed because of the servanthood, the love, the presence of someone else.
Cared.
Yes.
I mean, when I was 15, I got arrested. So my famous statement for every kid is, don't be stupid.
Don't be stupid.
That's,
yeah.
By the way, you can quote me on that.
That's good.
Don't be stupid.
That's great advice.
So I got arrested when I was 15, and I never had somebody come back around for me.
Mm.
Like, because I was that kid, and I was the Christian kid who grew up in the church, I knew better. I got arrested with another kid from the church, but it was okay for him, but it wasn't okay for me. So the church, I had some church hurt there.
Mm-hmm.
I had some, you know, I felt isolated. I felt alone. But at one point, if one person would have come along and said, you know what, you made a really stupid mistake. Now, what are we going to do?
Yeah.
You know, and that's where I think this gets lost in society today. But Student Impact happens to be the place where Sadie and all of her friends aren't the same people that she's hanging out with at Impact. I mean, we've got the greatest diversity of kids. 20% of our kids are special needs, and you don't know it.
Mm.
I have special needs children. I have 2 special needs kids. I have kids on the autism spectrum. You know, we have, and so I have a passion for serving those kids anyway. But when they come to Student Impact, they're not pitied or put in a different place. We just play Uno with them like mm-hmm. they're anybody else.
Oh, yeah. It's their favorite thing.
And it's their favorite thing because you know what? Everyone wants to be loved.
Yeah.
And nobody wants to be loved differently, right? They're tired of being loved differently.
Yeah.
They're tired of people seeing them as a kid with Down syndrome. They just want to be a teenager.
Yeah.
And so when they come there, and the football player and a cheerleader and the theater kid and all of these different kids are coming together, the melding of life that happens at Student Impact, man, it's so what the church should be because there's no gossip because we don't allow it. Mm. There's no purple. Boys are blue, yeah, girls are pink. Yeah, you can't be purple. Okay. And so, you know, nobody's allowed to touch because that makes us feel isolated.
Yeah.
Great. You want to have a girlfriend or a boyfriend? Have that. Not here.
Right.
Okay. Sit next to each other. Nobody needs to touch. You know, we don't isolate people. You know, if you're not feeling like you're part of something, have you tried to reach out? So we teach these real life skills to kids that are from all over the spectrum. I mean, some of our kids are the wealthiest kids in Westfield and some of our kids are the poorest, but you never know it inside the building.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you never know it at basketball.
I love it. And so the thing I love about what you guys are doing as well, Danyele, is it's not like you have like a staff of like 80 people. I mean, you got two full-time staff members. You've got the house, you know, and so much of this is donation run. So I'm sure maybe somebody's listening right now and they say, you know what? Like the tough part is I'm inspired. I don't know how to find time right now, you know, to do basketball or Uno, or maybe there's something else I'm involved in with my church or something at the school system or whatever it may be. But man, I could write a check. I could actually help you guys out because you guys, I'm assuming it's nonprofit. It's a donation based situation.
Yes.
Running a nonprofit myself, I know every penny counts. So talk to me about that.
So we typically run with two full-time staff on about $150,000 to $180,000 a year.
Yep.
And we serve, you know, 200 kids a week. So it is all donation-based. So like I say, anything that we can do to take our overhead down, the casseroles, for instance.
Yeah.
If I don't have to pay for food, and kids like home-cooked better.
Yeah.
So anything, it can be that simple. We sell pop. And so if you donate a case of pop to me, I can turn that into $15.
Mm.
You know, little small niblets of things that you can do. You can always donate cash on our website and things like that. But quite frankly, we love the fact that people just think of us.
Mm.
Like we'll get little packages from Costco or Sam's or, you know, some big box store where, you know, there'll be a case of paper towels. That's amazing. Like, I celebrate over toilet paper like people shouldn't. People should not be as excited about the toilet paper that we get. But it's such a special gift that somebody thought of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Is this something, Danyele, with Sadie being here and you know, senior in high school, is this something where maybe even a mom and a daughter or a dad and a son, like they could serve together and come and be a part of this as far as even families serving together and being there together?
We have lots of opportunities for families to serve together. We run a program called Food Rescue.
Okay.
And that's where we rescue food from the schools that comes off your kid's plate that they don't want, that's prepackaged fruit, milk, juice, or, you know, cheese, all that. And so we gather that up on a Friday and we serve about 30 families in Westfield fresh food every week, and we deliver it. It takes a lot of hands and feet to do that.
Okay.
So there on the ACTIVATEINDY site, there is some opportunities to come and serve with your family.
Phenomenal.
To do that. And it's just, you know, if nothing else, kids need to see that life isn't the way that they think it is every single day.
Yeah.
I mean, I have four of my own kids. We fostered 11 more, and heaven knows how many more that we've had in and out of our household. But every kid thinks that they are the poorest kids and everyone doesn't have, everyone has more than them.
Mm.
Everyone needs to see the people that we serve with Food Rescue.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone needs to see that these are normal families that are fighting really hard and working two jobs and they're not being lazy, but they just can't make ends meet.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, Danyele, if somebody right now, they're listening, I know they can go to activateindy.com, great website for you to get information about how to serve and the amazing work that so many nonprofits are doing around our city. But if people say, you know what, Student Impact is what I've been looking for, I want to partner up with Danyele, I want to meet Sadie, I want to be able to make a difference in the Westfield area, what's the best way for them to get in contact with you guys?
The best way is through the website. There's, if you're interested in serving or anything else, there's a forms page, and you can just say, I'd like to do this.
Okay.
So because we work with kids, you have got to have a background check. Then once that's complete, then we interview and we go from there.
What's the website?
www.therockwestfield.org.
Phenomenal. So you guys, and you're there ready to go every day?
Every day.
Every day.
Wow.
Every day. I volunteered 2 hours a week, or no, not 2 hours a week, two hours a day. So it's about 10 hours a week, but now it's going to be more since I'm interning. So at the end of high school, I'm going to have over 1,000 volunteer hours just at Student Impact.
Wow.
Where I've just worked with kids and helped them, and it's pretty wonderful.
And learn how to lead
kids
and not just normal life, but how to lead them in a life of Christ and explain to them what life is really about.
I love
it. In 1,000 hours. Who would want their kid? This is deep commitment. I mean, you see why you love a kid like Sadie.
Yeah.
I mean, she's just that awesome.
Yeah. Wow. I love it. I'm inspired by what you guys are doing. And I know that you are right now as you're listening. And this is a simple, simple way for you to make a massive difference in our city. If you're in the Westfield area or you know how to drive to Westfield, this is a phenomenal way for you to get involved. Go check it out. It's therockwestfield.org. Or if you want more information, just jump on the ACTIVATEINDY.com website. But Danyele, Sadie, man, thank you for what you're doing in our city. Thank you for the difference that you're making and for sharing your story today on the podcast. Joy and honor to meet both of you ladies. I really, really appreciate it.
Thank you for having us.
Thanks for listening to another episode of the Born to Be / Radio Theology / the greatest podcast ever listened to by anyone on the face of the planet.
Woo-woo.
We'll catch you next time.